And welcome everyone to this webinar hosted by Toradex. We are thrilled to have you. And today we're going to talk about how to get ahead with early access to the NXP i.MX 9.5 Verdin Evaluation Kit. And we're here to learn you, to teach you how to do that. Today with us is Dan Loop, Vice President and GM of the Automotive Edge Processing at NXP. My name is Mohamed Raad. I'm product manager at Toradex. And just before diving in to the webinar, let me cover a few organizational points. Please use the chat window of the webinar tool if you have any technical issues and wish to let us know. At the end of the session, we will have an interactive Q&A. You can type your questions in the chat window at any moment, and we'll pick them up at the end. The webinar will be recorded and made available for on-demand viewing later on. And with this, let's get started. So I'll begin today with a brief overview of who is Toradex and what we do. So Toradex focuses on making embedded computing easy to use, so get simple access to the latest technology for your product development. We are doing so by providing you with highly reliable ARM system on modules, or SOMs, and including software and support. We strive to offer the lowest cost of ownership to you. This doesn't mean just the module price, but also considerations of aspects like your development time, time to market, and long-term maintenance. We are proud of being able to have industry-leading support, including a very active community and a developer page with over 800 articles, which is updated daily. As you can see here, we have offices and support warehouses all around the world. Here's a short overview of our products. We have three SOM families, Apalis, Verdin, and Colibri, where you can seamlessly scale from i.MX 6 to i.MX 7 and to the i.MX 8 with our pin-to-pin compatibility inside product families. We are also providing production quality to these production quality software to these modules. You will learn about that a little bit later. And today we would like to really give a shout out to NXP and our long-lasting partnership. We've been an EBS partner since 2014, have deployed millions of modules globally, and have been developing over 25 i.MX based products. We are very proud of this partnership, and we are proud to be a platinum partner of NXP. I'd like to take a moment here to explain to you our focus applications as we are optimizing our products and offering to these specific industries and applications. So we tend to healthcare, industrial and robotics applications, transportation, logistics, and the agricultural sector. And finally, you can also see our products in the energy renewables sector, as well as in smart city equipment. Typical projects with customers have annual volumes of around 500 to 100,000 pieces. And at the moment, Toradex itself has over 3,000 active customers. Some of you are here with us today, so welcome. And the others who are still not our customers, we wish that you become our customers very soon after this. So apart from highly reliable SOMs or system on modules, Toradex also provides production ready software, including reference images for the Yocto project. Toradex is also active in mainlining code for its SOMs. And here we would like to talk about Torizon OS, which is a free offering from Toradex. It's an open source, easy to use industrial Linux distribution, focusing on lowering your time to market, and is something you can use directly out of the box It's based on open software. You have no lock-in and you can adjust it to your needs. Torizon OS comes with an automotive grade update client based on the Optane framework, allowing you simple, safe, and secure software updates. As an example, software updates are even safe if you cut or lose power at the worst possible moment. Some of you that have been to our booth at Embedded World last year have tried the try to break it demo. We're not successful. So it is proven in real life. We also focus on security, frequent updates, and simple access to hardware security features. This makes it easy for you to develop a secure device. We also have a real-time option for Torizon OS available, and then modern CI/CD processes make sure that Torizon OS has a stable release every time it comes out. It is built with the Octo project and utilizes Docker for software containerization, allowing you to tap into a vast software ecosystem. And then Torizon is our IoT platform, which goes basically, it's an easy to use industrial IoT platform. It is easy to use, secure, reliable, thanks to a full stack integration that we do here at Toradex that spans from hardware up to the cloud. We are focusing on three core needs of customers: speed, which equates to time to market. You can develop more efficiently with the resources that are available. You develop products and features and iterate on them often. And we want you to focus on your products, core expertise, and your own value add. Then we have security with IP protection, data, and of course, company reputation and brand, as well as a focus on complying with regulations. This is more and more a topic now with the EU Cyber Security and Resilience Act. And then in the end, reliability. This is very important for mission critical applications. We want you to be able to build reliable devices that you can rely on, reduce failures in the field, and most importantly, avoid costly downtime. So in a nutshell, Toradex is a full stack provider of turnkey solutions for Linux-based industrial IoT devices. Our offering ranges from highly reliable system on modules, production grade Linux distribution in the form of Torizon OS, and a state-of-the-art IoT platform, allowing you to securely manage, control, and update your IoT devices. And with that, today, I would like to take a little bit of your time, be a little bit interactive, and try out a poll for today. So have you used a Toradex SOM before? You should be seeing the poll right now. So please take a moment and respond to the poll with yes or no. And if you know the SOM family you've been using, if you've been using multiple ones, please choose the latest you've used. All right, I'm gonna be giving it a couple more seconds. Very good, let's close. Okay, that is actually very, very nice. I'm very happy that we are able today to have around 80% who haven't used our SOMs before. And I hope that today you change your mind and come join us. With that, let's talk about today's main focus, which is the i.MX95 system on chip from NXP. I will hand it over to you, Dan.
Thanks, Mohamed. So as Mohamed said, I'm Dan Loop. I'm the Vice President and GM for the Automotive Edge Processing product line at NXP. And we're an integral part of the 9.5 introduction. But if we look across our market segments, right, we're also supporting i.MX 9.5 in the the IoT space. So I have counterparts there who are driving that initiative, as well as the industrial space for i.MX 95. The automotive piece of it obviously is a big part of it. So I'm online today to discuss some of the attributes. But please don't think it's an automotive only product, right? So the 95, it's our, you know, really our most powerful i.MX processor we've released to date. A lot of new stuff coming in i.MX 95 that we haven't had in any of our other products. We have an internal ML engine called Neutron that's built into the i.MX 95. This delivers a two tops neural net, you know, processing performance, but it's really benchmark specific. We benchmark against some of our other devices that contain integrated ML, and we see about 2x performance on the same number of tops. So the engine is very efficient. It's really benchmarking well in the lab today, and it's going to be great when we get it out and more enablement around it with the IQ, the tools that we have, so customers can take advantage of that integration that we haven't had in a lot of our other products before. The other piece that we're really excited about, not just for automotive, but also for industrial, is a full integrated safety island, real-time core, Cortex M7, which is integrated. That's SIL2 or ASIL-B rated. So we have a full safety island that customers can take advantage of. And if you're familiar with the i.MX resource domain control, you can then, you know, assign peripherals to that domain and have a complete safety island with the peripherals of your choice around that. So really, really a new first for i.MX. We also have a new GPU. So those of you who have used our multimedia products before are probably familiar with the GPUs we've used in the past from another supplier. This is our first implementation of a new ARM Mali GPU, the 310. It's benchmarking better than even our i.MX8 Quasimax device that we have today, which has two GPUs. And when we daisy chain those GPUs, the i.MX 95 is actually outperforming it in the lab today. So again, in terms of the raw processing performance of the ARM cores, 6 A55s, plus the GPU, plus the NPU, the chip is really, you know, above and beyond what we've had in the past. So a lot of neat stuff that everyone can take advantage of. The other part is we are supporting LPDDR5. So this is our highest speed DDR part. It's a 32-bit interface running at 3200. So we're running, again, benchmarked in the lab at 6400 megatransfers per second. So really, really good performance we're seeing. Target applications we'll get into in the next slides. Automotive, obviously, expanding our cockpit presence, some also connectivity domain control, and the cluster applications that we see here. So we look at the infotainment side. The chip is really built to handle, you know, multiple displays. We can drive up to four panels with the interfaces that we have, daisy chain through LVDS. There's the safety integration is, again, a new thing for i.MX. We have software, if you're familiar with our SafeAssure software that we put on the i.MX 8 products, that is moving over into the safe domain of the i.MX 95, and then it'll be available as an ASIL-B application for you to take advantage of through our software services team. So there we have a safe display application, a safe camera application, as well as a safe audio application. So really, really rounds out what we've done in the past relative to functional safety. The integration is great. There's the safety domain in automotive. Typically, we run AUTOSAR there. It can eliminate an external MCU in a lot of cases, depending on the I/O needs. And of course, the AI functionality that we put in now with the integrated ML is going to really add a lot of value in terms of what we see coming in the Android domain and other places that are demanding higher levels of machine learning. On the connectivity side, you know, we're seeing a lot of need for more performance in what we'd say like a smart antenna type platform, or what we call a connectivity domain controller, where all of the wireless interfaces are connected through a single module. This doesn't take advantage of the multimedia functionality, but we're definitely seeing a need for the ML plus the performance of the A55s in this area. And we actually have a reference design based on our previous generation i.MX 8 XL product that's available today called the Orange Box. The next generation, obviously, we'll be moving that to the i.MX 95, so we're really excited about that. So industrial, again, the taking a little bit of a step back here, if we go back to i.MX 6 days, this is really kind of the process we're following with i.MX 95, where we're a multi-market product, same device suitable for IoT devices, automotive devices, and industrial. So for industrial, we're focused a lot around the automation pieces. Again, the safety island comes in, it's fully SIL 2 rated. We're doing the same level of safe HMI support, multiple displays, as well as the vision processing with the camera interfaces. And the other thing I forgot to mention is there's an integrated ISP now. This is another NXP technology that we're integrated into the i.MX 95 that we're enabling to eliminate, you know, cameras that have integrated ISPs. Now we can use the ISP within the device itself and then support larger sensors. And then we're tailoring that that ISP to a number of the sensors that are on the market. On the other side, on medical, and very similar applications there around high security. So we can use our Edge Lock Secure Enclave to manage keys, protect data. So this is the second implementation of that. If you're familiar with the i.MX 93, it has a similar island. The 95 then advances that somewhat to on the Edge Lock side. And in real time, right, the real time control of the safety island with the Cortex M7 is great for some of the medical devices that need hard real-time requirements for some of the I/O that are driving different actuation within a medical environment. Then of course, for IoT on the next slide, smart home and smart office are big focuses for us. We have taking advantage of a lot of the same peripherals again around vision for autonomous home applications. Using the ISP, using the ML engine for machine learning in different environments, the high security aspect of the Edge Lock to go, and then of course the networking. I didn't mention either. This is our highest speed networking product that we've ever done with the i.MX family. We're actually taking some technology that we've used in the past from our Layerscape devices called the NetC peripheral, and we have a 10 gigabit port. I think Mohamed will talk a little bit about the networking attributes in the future slides. Around smart office, again, with cameras, the amount of cameras we can support with the dual MIPI interfaces, up to 4K and the high-speed I/O, really good, really well-rounded product for some of these applications around the IoT space. Thank Toradex for allowing us to participate in this. I think this is a great opportunity for a lot of customers to get access to i.MX 95 before we really have a big launch of it. So if some of you who've been around for a while with i.MX 6, we did this with a board that we put out like just in the early stages of our development that gave customers the ability to really get involved in the and really understand what we're doing before they really make a decision on whether they want to engage on a product. So again, thanks for Toradex to put this platform together. We're super excited to work with them. And I'll turn it back over to Mohamed to go through some of the other material.
All right. Thank you, Dan. I mean, yeah, we also at Toradex want to thank you and NXP for this amazing opportunity to be here present on the Alpha program and to be running the EVK that we're going to talk about a little bit later. We're all excited and we really can't wait to know what customers will be building with i.MX 95. There's a huge potential there, and I want to take the time now to walk you through some of the major functionalities and new features that we will have on the i.MX 95. As Dan mentioned before, the new NPU called Neutron, which is an internal development from NXP, so it's an NXP IP that is optimized for performance and power efficiency. It will be capable in terms of a benchmark with the current figures of about 2 times more inferences per second compared to the i.MX 8M Plus or i.MX 93. Now, on next one, compute power is a very important improvement over existing SOCs from NXP. You will be able to get configurations with up to 6 times A55 cores, which giving you a performance boost of about 2.5 times compared to an i.MX 8M Plus. Coupling that with LPDDR5 RAM support, and you're really set for faster task execution and the ability to work with crisp animations on your user interfaces. Power efficiency is central to the i.MX 9.5 architecture, allowing you flexibility on core utilization and advanced power consumption optimization. This happens through you turning off one of the six cores or multiple of those, and then also dynamically controlling the clock speed of each of the cores individually. So you can really optimize your power consumption in the application you're developing. And again, as Dan mentioned, the high performance compute wouldn't be complete without a rich set of high speed interfaces. So for the first time, we have on i.MX product a 10 gigabit Ethernet port, along with two other gigabit Ethernet ports with TSN capability, and other interfaces such as PCI Express Gen 3 and then USB 3.1. Again, safety and reliability are key in the i.MX 9.5. The safety domain, the separation between safety domain and application domain, coupled with the NXP Safe Assure framework software, you will be able to get a true ASIL-B or SIL-2 implementation, including hardware fault checking for safety elements. And then with the EdgeLock Secure Enclave, the i.MX 9.5 is more than ready to meet the security requirements of tomorrow's embedded products. And then last but not least, as Dan mentioned as well before, the addition of the new ARM Mali G310 3D GPU, coupled with the LPDDR5 RAM we mentioned before, will open the gates for immersive graphics and up to 4K 30fps resolutions on the MIPI DSI interface. So it is a very exciting product and a very powerful offering from NXP. One more poll for you. This is more about how do you feel about the computing power of the i.MX 9.5. You feel it's too powerful for your application? You feel it's just right, just what you need? Or do you still need more performance? All right. I'm gonna give it a couple more seconds. I see people are still voting. All right. So I think, Dan, you're gonna love this. There you go. It's just right. It's a perfect fit. So I'm really happy to also see this.
For those of you who say it's too powerful, stay tuned. I'll say we're still working on the 9.5 series, and there's more to come towards scaling down. Let's leave it at that. We haven't announced anything, but I'll leave that as a teaser for you guys.
All right. Excellent. Thank you, Dan. And then we're today introducing you to the i.MX 9.5 Verdin Evaluation Kit. We've introduced this kit back in November in the Tech Days, NXP Tech Days in Detroit. It was under the name Titan EVK, for those of you who may have been there. Given recent developments that I will get to also later in the slides, we've decided to rebrand the EVK. So it will be named the i.MX 9.5 Verdin Evaluation Kit. We'll continue to keep the name Titan as an internal project code. You might see it on some documents or some of the PCB design or any code, but we will not use it on any official branding anymore. So if some of you have heard of the Titan EVK, it's just the same rebranded to Verdin Evaluation Kit. All right. So our main goals from the i.MX 9.5 EVK, Verdin EVK, were to allow early access customers to take advantage of all of the novelties that we've talked about and the features of the i.MX 9.5, and provide you with an easy to use comprehensive software and develop hardware and software development platform. Also providing you a versatile platform that is compatible with a wide variety of hardware products or peripherals and software frameworks. And most importantly for us, we want you to get started quickly prototyping your next products. And we want to help you, and we want to do our best so that you reduce your time to market with i.MX 9.5 powered products. As you can see here, we've added for functional safety and reliability, an EEPROM and an octal spy flash. In terms of expandability, you will have an MPCIe slot and an M.2 key slot, allowing you now to work with Wi-Fi 6. I will touch on that later on. For the first time for us as well, we are integrating a 16 gigabyte LPDDR5 RAM on the evaluation kit. And then you will be able to monitor closely power consumption and optimize your applications and products. This is what we talked about before on the kind of the big features slide. You'll be able to really measure using this evaluation kit how much power consumption you have from your application as well as from the peripherals that you are enabling and connecting to the evaluation kit. Many display interfaces are there for you to create the best user interfaces you can think of. You have the quad lane MIPI DSi and an octal lane LVDS and some audio as well. And then working with the machine vision capabilities, you'll be able to connect up to 8 cameras with 2 quad lane MIPI CSIs. These will be on this side of the board. So you'll have the primary CSI interface here, which has the mini SAS connector, you know, from other NXP evaluation kits. And then the DSI interface here, which can also work as a CSI interface. So you can have both here using these pluggable mezzanine cards, and you can customize however you want. And again, we've talked about the high-speed interfaces. So there is a 10 gigabit Ethernet port with the other 2 gigabit Ethernets. One of them will be an automotive Ethernet. So that, stay tuned for that. We need an update there, but it's coming. All right. And then one more poll for you guys, keep you a little bit busy today. I'm also sweating, so. This is an interesting one. So what new feature of the i.MX 9.5 are you most excited about? All right, I see that 50% of you have voted. I'm gonna give it a couple more seconds. All right, so this is very interesting. Also for you, Dan, the MPU and functional safety. I would have also said functional safety domain.
That, yeah, I think it's interesting. You know, it's some of the newer technologies obviously are coming through here. And the ISP obviously a little bit more challenging to enable, but we're working very hard on that. So hopefully we can get everyone over on the ISP at some point too, but really, really excited about the stuff that we're bringing out in the 9.5.
That is amazing. All right. And finally here, as I mentioned before, we've made big efforts in order to have a large ecosystem of hardware peripherals available for you with out-of-the-box support. So we'll be having multiple cameras, multiple displays, the i.MX 9.5 Verdin EVK will ship with Wi-Fi 6 included. We have a Maya W2 module from uBlocks. It's powered by NXP IW612, a chipset that will ship with the EVK directly installed on the M.2 connector. And then in order for you or your developers to get started quickly and more comfortably, we will also ship the i.MX95 Verdin EVK with a DSI to HDMI adapter that will allow you to connect very quickly to a display on your desk. It's much more comfortable also for developers to work with it like that. So yeah, they can get started quickly and also comfortably developing. We've been talking a lot, but I wanted to show you the EVK live. So this, if you can see the timestamp on the top right, this is from, I think, today morning. You can see here the i.MX95 Verdin EVK running on NXP's BSP with our 10.1-inch LVDS display. And it is rendering a beautiful warrior there. So this is all 3D GPU. So I really wanted to give the NXP team there a huge shout out, because we've had a very smooth bring up. We have, I would say, about 90% of the interfaces already working properly and brought up. So we're really happy about that, and we feel very confident for the future activities that we have planned on the i.MX95 and on the EVK itself. All right, I'll give it one more turn. Let's go. All right, from the software perspective, we want to be able to give you very easy and quick way to start evaluation. That's why we will be pre-installing Torizon OS on all i.MX95 Verdin EVKs, and you'll be able to run application demos from multiple partners, software partners like Qt, Codesys. You have Ozone as well with for AI and machine learning demos, and then Crank as well with UI. So we're engaging closely with these software partners to enable them with kits early on, so that when you when our customers receive the kits, they will find a rich library of demos and sample applications to get started with. Just want to talk about Torizon OS here. The pre-installed version of Torizon OS you will have here is built on top of NXP's BSP. And you will have complete freedom from there to build your own images with Yocto and install them on the EVK. So our goal here is not to lock you in, but to kind of give you a very quick out-of-the-box experience. But then you have full liberty to use NXP's BSP and then build your own Yocto images and then continue from there. We'll also make sure that you have proper and comprehensive documentation as well as quick start guides to help you through this evaluation process. So for us, the reducing time to market is in our DNA. So in this collaboration with NXP, it's no different. The i.MX 95 Verdin EVK will have Toradex's DNA somewhere in it, and we will continue to strive and to make your time to market as short as possible and your development experience as smooth and easy as possible. I promise this is the last one. So one more poll. I wanted to see when would you guys need the Verdin EVK? So do you need it yesterday? Would you need it in the next 3 months? Maybe during 2024? Or you're still not sure about the need? Let's see. All right, I see half of you have voted already. Gonna give it maybe a couple more seconds. All right. So it's not as sharp as the other ones, but there is interest. I mean, more than half of you still need it this year. So that is encouraging. That puts us under a bit of pressure, but we kind of like that. How do you feel about it, Dan?
No, I think it's great. I think we're on track to start delivering these with Toradex in Q2. And again, to your point, Mohamed, on the VSP, I guess I should let everyone know too that we're using this in our lab. So our VSP is being tested both on our EVK as well as the Toradex board before it goes out. So it's going to be a really solid start for anyone that gets started even earlier. Obviously, some of the more difficult peripherals will be, it takes some time to enable over the course of the year, but we've got a lot of stuff, like you said, Mohamed, up and running now. So we're really excited to get this out and get it in the hands of some customers to evaluate, to understand if they do have a project that needs it, right? To see what features we have there. I think it's a great avenue to get started.
Totally agree. All right. And then since most of you are wondering when can I get it? What's the timeline? How are things going? All right. So I want to go through a little bit the schedule with you. So we've had the initial announcement of the i.MX95 Verdin EVK in Detroit Tech Days back in November. And for the last months, we've been working together with NXP's BSP team and hardware teams to get the EVK brought up. And the hardware itself validated. So by the end of Q1 this year, so next couple of months, the first NXP BSP release for the i.MX95 Verdin EVK will be ready. And we will be working closely with software partners to start preparing demos and sample applications that we want you to be able to take full advantage of, as well as come see it in action in April this year at Embedded World. So it will be the EVK and the demos will be there at NXP's booth for sure, and at the Toradex booth. So we strongly encourage you to come visit us. We can talk face to face there at Embedded World. You can have a look at it yourself, touch the prototype, and get a feel of it and the demos. We will be shipping shortly after Embedded World 2024, and we'll be shipping it to approved alpha customers. And then together with NXP, we'll continue supporting you, getting your feedback on how we can improve until Q3 of 2025, when the i.MX95 SOC will hit the market with volume quantities. So this is the kind of the schedule we have right now. So I strongly urge you now, if you haven't already done so, please apply to the i.MX95 Early Access Program. You can do that by visiting the link shown on the QR code there, or in the webinar chat. It's also up there for you. So please, there's you will go in, you will be able to apply there. That will secure you an early spot to already start evaluating and developing on i.MX95 with practically a year head start on general availability. And then with NXP software support, with Torizon OS and the extensive partner software enablement, along with the diverse hardware ecosystem that is available for you from day one, you're getting a genuine and effective head start here on development. We're working hard to make sure that your time to market with i.MX95 is greatly reduced. So please visit our landing page and apply for your early access slot. It's really important. You'll have the link. I'm going to move on. And then one more thing before we get to the Q&A section. As you kind of were guessing, we've taken a step, and we are thrilled to introduce you to our latest addition to the Toradex family on the Verdin SOM form factor, the Verdin i.MX95 SOM. So We had chosen, you saw it in the images before, we had chosen elongated form factor on the EVK for rapid bring-up needs, as well as to fit, let's say, higher power requirements that we were seeing from, let's say, early data on the SOC. However, now that we have more data from the bring-up activities, we have a better understanding of technical requirements and performance, real performance of the i.MX 95 SOC, we've decided that our volume SOC will be on the Verdin form factor that some of you may be accustomed to or heard of, and our plan is to release along with the i.MX 95 general availability in Q3 2025. So in here, we continue to stay true to our values of scalability, pin compatibility, and ease of use. The Verdin i.MX 95 will continue on this tradition. It will be pin-to-pin compatible with our existing Verdin family SOMs, like the i.MX 8M Mini and the 8M Plus. Software compatibility and continuity are ensured with our software offering, and whether you already are using our Verdin modules, or you want to start early with the i.MX 95 for your future product, you are able currently to start with confidence your development on any of our existing Verdin modules, and then transition in due time to the Verdin i.MX 95. We'll be guiding you through this process with documentation and guidelines, and making sure that your transition is as smooth as possible and as quick as possible. So we'll keep you updated in 2024 on the Verdin i.MX 95. Stay tuned, follow us on LinkedIn and our other socials so you don't miss out on this. So it was really a pleasure for me today to be with you. I want to thank you, Dan, from NXP for the valuable contribution today, and for this amazing opportunity for us to be a part of the i.MX 95 Early Access Program. I don't know if you have any last words as well.
No, again, thanks for Toradex too for rolling this out. Again, as you said, Mohamed, it's been a really, probably one of the smoothest bring-ups we've had on an i.MX product to date. And getting this board out as fast as we can is our top priority right now. It's gonna be, I think it's gonna be kind of top end of our i.MX 9 family as we continue to release more products over the course of the next couple of years. So really thanks to Toradex to get this going.
Thank you so much, Dan. We'll be moving now to the Q&A session. So if you have any questions, please do not hesitate to type them into the chat window, and we'll do our best to kind of go through them all together with Dan. So there's this question: can you give a performance comparison figure between the i.MX 8 Quad Max GPU and the i.MX 95 GPU? Is it a 2x performance upgrade, more?
It's not, I don't believe it's 2. I think it's I don't have the exact data, but it's definitely higher. In the Quad Max, it's a totally different GPU architecture, which also brings in some more memory efficiencies, which helps it in a lot of ways. The pixel throughput is much better. So depending on the specific benchmark, we see much higher numbers in terms of the pixel throughput. In terms of the general, like Manhattan and those types of benchmarks, it's definitely better, but it's difficult for me to say exactly how much.
I can give one, maybe, on the, I have them, let's say on Manhattan at full HD, it's about, 30% more efficient, something like that.
That seems about right, yeah.
So you'll be able to do here the figure is around 20 FPS for there, so yeah. Let's see, we have a lot of questions actually. Where can I run AutoStore, on the Cortex M7 or the M33? That's a tough one.
That's a good question. So the M33, if you're familiar with the architecture of the i.MX 8 Quad Max and the 8 QXP devices and 8XL, There's a system controller in this i.MX 9.5. This is our first instantiation of that that type of architecture in the i.MX 9s. So the M33 is kind of reserved as what we call a system manager now. There will be the M7, of course, for AutoSAR in the device, or a safe OS can be run there too.
All right. I think some of the people have clinged onto your teaser. So I'm not sure, Dan, if you can share if there's a documentation available or something on the other versions of the i.MX 9.5, like with less A15.
Not yet, but it's. I'll just again for the teaser. Think of what we had with i.MX 6, with the products we had there and how they scaled down. That's the strategy is the same. So there's a, you know, there's going to be a pin compatible lower end product coming. I'll just leave it at that. And if you have an NDA with us, we'll be happy to talk more about it.
All right. There's a nice question about Android OS, that I can take part of it. I think the Android BSP is from NXP is scheduled in Q3 this year.
Yeah, we're trying to pull that in. So I think that we should have the base Android earlier, and that will probably be the Android Automotive version, which we're looking at, you know, trying to accelerate that. Everything's built off of Linux, and that's where we start. I guess the other thing to note there is that we're also enabling our key partners on the automotive side. Both QNX and Green Hills actually are waiting for these boards. And for other partners that may be on the webinar, I know you're probably familiar with what we've done in the past to get to enable partners with half-price hardware from NXP. The Toradex board is actually less than half the price of our EVK. So we're recommending everyone, you know, engage with Toradex from a partner perspective to enable a product. But Android is coming for sure. It's just going to take us a little bit more time.
All right. Another interesting one on displays. Dan said it supported up to 4 displays. Not sure it was 4 displays or 4K displays.
Well, that's 4K total on the pixel side. With, you know, in automotive, so again, you gotta remember the source. So I'm the automotive guy. So with some of the LVDS configurations that are available from FPD-Link and GMSL, we can daisy chain off of the peripherals that we have to support multiple panels. So there are not 4 interfaces on the device, but we can support up to 4 displays, and the total pixel range is around 4K by 2K.
All right. There's what is support for hypervisors? That's an interesting one.
We didn't mention it, but there is a full system MMU on the product, and we'll be enabling hypervisor partners as well to put their virtualization on top of the A cores that we have.
All right. Next one is, what Yocto version is the BSP based on? At the moment, from what I've also seen with the developers from Torizon developers, they're working with NAND build, so Yocto project, I think 4.3. I don't know if you have more info, Dan, on that.
No, that one I do not know. I'll claim manager on that one. I don't
do you have SIL4 standard support, SIL4?
It's SIL2, so not to 4. I think 4 is similar to ASIL-D, which requires lockstep, and that's not on the product.
Mm-hmm. Another interesting one, are the CAN, Automotive Ethernet, or Ethernet in general, and PCI Express covered by the safety island?
They can be interfaced to the safety island. Again, that's through the resource domain control. It's our standard NXP peripherals, which are built under the same safety process, so it can be considered part of that safety island.
All right.
As long as you configure them as such, right? So you can configure at build time whether you want those peripherals to be attached to the A cores or the M core, and then with our XRDC technology, you can dynamically change that within the life cycle.
All right. Is EVK documentation already available? Partly, yes, and more coming. So at the moment, you can visit the landing page that is on the chat window. And if you scroll down, you have a features table as well as an initial block diagram showing you what to expect there. And then we're working throughout the quarter to have a better documentation on the EVK itself that is available to the Alpha program customers, and then some quick start guides as well. Let's see. What GStreamer plugins are provided for video or image processing? That I don't know.
I don't know.
Right, we're claiming manager on this.
I'll claim manager on that.
The 10 gigabit Ethernet does not support TSN. Is that correct?
No, it does. I believe it does support TSN. It's a TSN cert is from our NetC peripheral. Yeah.
Yeah. So can industrial cameras work with it at high speed? If you're using the Ethernet cameras, you can go to the gigabit, so that will be quite high performance. If you're using quad lane CSI, that will also be high performance there. You can also use USB 3. It will be 3.1 Gen 1. So hopefully it will match the needs you have for the cameras. And then as we mentioned, with the ability to have two CSI ports, you'll be able to do about 8 cameras. Now, of course, not all at 4K. That is interesting. Let's see, Dan, that's maybe your internal competition at NXP. Is NXP planning to offer the i.MX 95 in the aerospace industry and support customers with associated avionics certification, like easing multi-core certification, for example?
Yeah, that one I'm not sure. I'll take that offline and talk to our aerospace guys. Typically we have done that in the past on some of our products on the networking side. I believe we are talking to some of those customers already on the 95, so I believe that is in the plan, but it's obviously outside of my automotive domain.
Here we have one that is quite technical as well. Will the ECDSA verification capability for V2X be comparable to the performance of i.MX 8X Lite?
That's a really good one. It will be. So we are using the same peripheral in this as part of the safety or the security strategy. We use it for a number of things, but it will have that same acceleration for ECDSA, as well as the SM234 for the China VDEX standards.
All right. I saw a couple of questions regarding PCI Express. So the mainly, if I take both of them, it will be, why do we only have one lane on each of the two ports? Is there a way for us to like kind of use the two lanes together? Or people think it might be limiting. I think with an NVMe, yes, okay, you will have a lesser throughput than if you have four lanes for sure, but it will be a significant boost. I don't know, Dan, if you know something we don't.
No, that one I don't have the answer to either.
That one is interesting. So for the supply of the i.MX 95 on the EVK, do we use a PIMIC? Is it on the SUM or on the evaluation board? So there is the evaluation kit gets a 12 volt input through the jack connector. You can do 8 to 24 or 8 to 28 volts also on another header. Then there is a DC-DC input that gives a 5-volt to the SOM. And then on the SOM itself, there are three different PMICs that are all from NXP. And then with the, I think, I don't know if we can mention the names, but the PMICs themselves will also have SIL2 capability. So you will be able to do all of the, let's say, rail monitoring as well using those PMICs. So yes, on the evaluation kit on the SOM, there are all the PMICs needed to power the SOM. You will just need to give it the proper rail. And then basically, if when you get into the alpha program after after you've been approved, you'll be able to get also like better documentation, schematics of the EVK. So you can also build according to that. Are we supporting PyTorch for deep learning? I think so. Dan, you can.
You know, yeah, that I'm not entirely sure. I believe that is something we are supporting.
Yes, there's TensorFlow here. I see. There will be like a full EIQ toolkit behind that, and then we have there's TensorFlow, PyTorch, there's even Cafe, and Onyx. Does using the safety classification require signing some specific NXP program?
It does require that there is a, you know, documentation that has to be provided to pass on for all of the safety certifications. So there is some interaction with our account teams that needs to be taken into account there. Yes.
All right. Are video codecs integrated into the CPU?
Not in the CPU. We actually have a video processor. We didn't mention it, but there's a new CPU as well in the i.MX 95. It's a chips and media block, which is we've used them in the past. This is the first time we've used them for, I don't think we used them in i.MX 8, but we use them now in the i.MX 9s. And up to HEVC is supported, so 264, all the standard flavors of video. It's all done in hardware, so there's no CPU needed there.
Yep. All right. I think we have 1 minute left. Any final questions? One of the people says thank you. So thank you all as well. All right. I don't think we have questions. What about the price of?
There's always a question on price.
Okay. Yes,
there's always NXP sales or your local distributor. That's my tagline for that one.
Come and meet us at Embedded World this year, and we'll discuss also pricing on our SOMs.
The feedback is always tell us the volume, and we'll discuss the price.
All right. Amazing. So thank you all for the very interactive session. We've seen a lot of engagement from everybody here. So it was a pleasure. Thank you, Dan, for taking the time with us. And yeah, we'll talk in the next webinar. Thank you.
All right. Thanks, everyone.